All right, welcome back. Many of us are either entertained or informed by a podcast, but instead of listening, have you considered making your own? Well, it's easier than you think. We brought in Eric Newsom, author of Make Noise, a creator's guide to podcasting, and he's here with some basics. It's so nice to have you. He actually went to Kent State.
That's true.
He's home. Mm-hmm. He's a local. Now you're in New Jersey.
Yeah. I work in New York and live in New Jersey.
And so when did you start podcasts?
I started podcasting in 2005,
okay.
Almost by accident.
Was this with Ted?
No, I've made actually three different podcasts with Ted, but I was at NPR at the time, and podcasting was very new at that time.
Sure.
And just kind of getting started, and we said, well, you know, we're an audio company, we should go out in the world and do this like everyone else, and kind of ended up growing NPR to be the largest distributor of podcasts in the world.
So what do you think makes it so popular? You think this is kind of just the beginning?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It's just the beginning. And on one hand, it's very overwhelming because as of last week, there are 900,000 different podcasts available for free today. Right?
Wow.
And some people think that's an overwhelming amount of choice.
Sure.
And then, others compare that. Well, that's roughly the number of websites that were available in 1997. So the internet has found new things to do in the last 23 years, and I'm sure podcasting will continue to grow. It's just choice. It's the ability to listen to something you want to, that you're interested in, mm-hmm. When you want to listen to it.
So talk about the difference between maybe radio and podcast, besides mm-hmm. the obvious.
Well, it's time, and it's also geography. It removes those two restrictions. So if you're used to listening or watching something at a certain time, you can now listen to it when you want to. Instead of it being on at 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock or 7 o'clock, you can listen while you walk the dog,
right.
Regardless of what time you're doing that, or when you're commuting, regardless of what time. And then it also removes geography too. So if you, in the Cleveland area, there are probably people who like, let's say, quilting or woodworking, right? For example, there are a number of people who like it, but not enough to make a radio show about or to make a, something substantial. But when you aggregate those people around the country, around the world, then all of a sudden it becomes a large enough community to support that. And people who are into those type of things can connect with other people.
So somebody who's listening, what would you suggest? I mean, like, how long in length should you make it? You don't want to make it too long.
No.
And my second question is how do you grab their attention in like 30 seconds, right?
Right.
Or they're goners.
Right. With 900,000 competitors, you really better be able to deliver immediately. And I think it's a matter of intention. A lot of people say, I'd like to start a podcast, but they don't think about really, who am I talking to or what do I have to say? Right? And spending a little bit of time up front, that's what the book really does, is helping people figure out how to spend a little bit of time up front to kind of define what you are mm-hmm. and understand, have a sense of intention, that can help you kind of cut through in that way. And whenever anybody asks me how long a podcast should be, I always say it should be as long as it needs to be and not a second longer, and probably should be 10 minutes shorter than it is.
Okay, that's good advice. You also have great advice on interviews because obviously you're not going to be talking the whole time, right?
Right.
That could get boring, so you'll be interviewing, which I learned a lot just for my job, mm-hmm. being on television, just from your book. You talk about your son in one of your chapters. You say, when you are talking, you aren't listening.
Right.
Okay?
That's something I say to him every day.
Every day. Right, and he rolls his eyes at you.
Yes.
So silence can be your friend in interviewing.
Yes, and also silence can be your friend of just like asking someone and then just stop talking. Shut up. Right? Listen. Mm-hmm. Great documentary filmmaker Errol Morris says that he used to do interviews on a 60-minute tape. Each side was 30 minutes cassette, and his goal was to never ask more than one question on one side of that tape.
Really?
So just be quiet, because, you know, when you ask someone a question, they give you an answer immediately, and if they're greeted with silence, they feel they need to rush in and say something.
Fill that dead
their
air.
Their first answer was what they planned to say, and the second answer is the more interesting thing that they're going to say.
You are so right. How am I doing so far?
You're doing great.
Okay. talk about, this will be my last question. If somebody's thinking about doing it, how do mm-hmm. they make it interesting? Where do they start? Something obviously that they may be passionate about. Mm-hmm. Flowers, you name it, furniture, or something maybe a little bit more deeper politics.
Rug hooking, for example, right? Let's
sure.
say you love rug hooking.
Right.
But if you're passionate about something, that's the most important thing, because
right.
you can't fake passion. You can't pretend to be interested in something. But if you have that, and you have something you want to say that you think other people need to hear, or you're speaking for a group of people, mm-hmm. and you really have a way of kind of saying what's on everyone's minds, that's the two most important keys. I'm just being passionate about something. All the technology is really easy, and it's
right.
really easy to learn. There are apps out in the world that you could just use this one app and it'll do everything, including helping you come up with your cover art for your podcast.
Wow.
All this in the app. You don't have to. It's, if you can buy something off of Amazon, you can make a podcast.
Okay.
It's that easy. The hard part is figuring out what you, not someone else, what you specifically have to say.
I like what you said at the very beginning. You French poet said, "A poem is never finished; it's only abandoned."
Right.
That's the same for a podcast episode.
Yes.
We're gonna leave him with that. You can get his book if you want to learn more. Eric is hosting in the evening at the Hudson Library and Historical Society. It's gonna be tonight at 7 o'clock. Mm-hmm. It's a free event, just like some podcasts. Mm-hmm. All that will be there, along with his book. You should really check it out. I mean, over 900,000 podcasts, right? Mm-hmm. So it's obviously the end thing and something maybe you could do, and who knows, make some money off of it. So thank you for coming in.
Oh, absolutely.
And welcome home. Say hi to your family.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Thanks, Eric.